Recently, I put together a full Amazon KDP tutorial that went through everything step by step. However, the only thing that we didn't cover in that video is how to actually create and set up your Amazon KDP account. So in this video, I'm going to walk you through exactly how to set up your Amazon KDP account. I'm even going to switch you over to the computer and we will go through this together step by step. Now, for those of you guys who are located outside of the United States, this video is going to be for you as well. I have a couple tricks that you can use in order to get your payment details so you can still get paid by Amazon. All right, guys, without further ado, let's get straight into this video. Okay, so switching over to the computer here, the very first thing I would do is go to Google and type in Amazon KDP. This is what the result should look like that you are looking for. Make sure that it says kdp.amazon. This means that you're going to the right place. So let's just click on this. And this is going to bring you to the Amazon KDP homepage. This is where you sign up to create an account. Again, this is totally free to do. So we've got two buttons here. We've got sign in and we've got join KDP. Once you go through this process and you have created your account, you will just come back and sign in every time. However, if this is your first time through, just click on the join KDP button. So there's only a couple steps in this process, but the very first step is to enter your first and last name, an email that you want associated with this account, and then a password. So I'm just going to fill this out with you. I'm just going to use an example here, Greg YouTube. Now for the email address, you can use an email address that is associated with your Amazon account or a totally different one. It's not going to matter which way you do it. Okay, and then set a password and then click on create your KDP account. Okay, and then this is going to send you a verification code to your email, so just go check your inbox. The reason for this step is it wants to make sure that there were no typos in your email address and to make sure that you actually own it. Okay, so once you've got that code, just type it in here and then click on create your Amazon account. Okay, so first things first, it's just going to give you all of the terms for Amazon KDP. You can read through these. I recommend at least just skimming this so you are familiar with them, and then just click on agree. And then just like that, it brings you into your Amazon KDP dashboard. However, we're not quite done yet. There are a couple steps that we have to take here in order to complete our account to make sure that we can publish our books and get paid by Amazon. The whole point of doing Amazon KDP is to make money. So you want to make sure that you get this part right so you can actually receive your payments. Okay, so the very first thing to do when you get to your dashboard, you're going to see this pop-up that says complete your account information. You can click on your account here, or you can click on it up top. Let's just click on it on the pop-up that they give us. And then we are going to run into a two-step verification here. It wants us to enter our phone number so it can text us a code. What Amazon is doing here is trying to protect themselves so that people don't come in and make multiple accounts all under their same name. So with that being said, just type in the phone number that you want to receive this code to, and then you can click on send one-time password. And then once you receive that, just enter it here and click on continue. So then this brings us to the actual account creation. So once you get to this page, there's only two sections here. So we have your identity, which is the first section we are looking at, and then your account. This is going to be kind of how you get paid and your bank information. So starting out here, we have your legal name. You want to put in your full name here, not your shortened nickname. Now for this example, I'm just going to use this name, Greg YouTube. But for you, you would put in your full legal name. This is the one that you either see on your driver's license or your ID or what you pay taxes with. Now next up, we fill in our address. So first pick your country. And then once you finish that, fill in your date of birth and your phone number. All right, once you've got all that filled out, just click on save and continue. And then just like that, it brings us into the second part of this account creation. So we finished your identity. We're now on your account. And these three boxes here are where people typically run into questions. So let's start with the first one here. So account details, you can have individual or corporation. Now, the reason that you would select one or the other is if you do have a business entity set up and you want this KDP account to be associated with that business, you would select corporation and you can enter the company name, the company address, the company phone number here. However, if you were just starting this on the side and you don't have a business set up, that is totally okay. You just click on individual. It's just going to put your first and last name that you entered before. Now, something that's really important to clarify here is that the guidelines for Amazon KDP specify that you can only have one Amazon KDP account per person. However, you can also have one Amazon KDP account per business. So that's where this comes into play. If you have an account set up under you individually, you can also have another account set up for a business. And then if you have multiple businesses set up down the road, you can have an Amazon KDP account set up for each one of those businesses. This is a technicality to Amazon KDP that most people don't know. And the reason for this is that once you create and build up an Amazon KDP business, there are people willing to buy those accounts from you. These are typically really big businesses that just want to continue diversifying. So they will actually be interested in buying your Amazon KDP account. And the easiest way for them to purchase that from you is if it is set up as a business. This essentially just turns it into a business acquisition. Now, I know that is a little bit technical and that will most likely come into play far down the road, but just know that whichever way that you set up this account, if you do need to change it down the road, so let's say you started it as an individual, you can change it later to a corporation if that makes it easier for you to sell that account, if that's something you're interested in later. Okay, so I know that's a lot of nitty-gritty details, but that is the first section right here. Now we're moving on to the second one, which is getting paid. This, I would say, is probably the most important section and also the most confusing section, so I'll make sure to walk you through every step here. So the first thing you want to do here is click on where is your bank. This is going to open a dropdown. Now what you're going to see is there are a lot of countries and regions listed here, but not all of them are. So if your country or region is not listed here, I'll show you what to do about this in a second. So I'm going to select United States, and then this is simply going to ask for our bank information. So if you have selected an individual up here, feel free to just use your personal account information. It can be either checking or savings, and you do not need to go out and set up a business account. Now, for some of you, this may seem obvious, but if you are setting this up as a business, I highly recommend using the business's bank account. It's going to keep all of your funds separate, all in one place, very organized and easy to track. So with that being said, this brings us into an issue that a lot of people will run into. So if you are located outside of the United States and your country or region is not listed or supported in this list, then there is an easy workaround for you. You just need to know what it is. So essentially, there's two different websites you can use to do this. The first one would be payoneer.com. And all you have to do is once you go to Payoneer, hover over freelancers and go to get paid by marketplaces. If you click on that, it's going to prompt you to create a Payoneer account, totally free to do. And then they will give you US banking information. So you can take the US bank information that they give you, go back over here, and you can still select United States as where your bank is, and then enter all of that information right here. Now, before we talk about the fees or the pricing to use Payoneer, which there is something that's kind of hidden, not many people know, I do want to show you one other option you can use. This one is called Wise.com. It used to be called TransferWise. So if you've heard of that, it's the same company. However, the important thing to know about using Wise is that you can use a personal account. You don't have to set up a business one. This is still going to allow you to get paid by Amazon. However, it's going to be 100% for free. So if you go and look at the pricing for Wise, you're going to see that creating your account is totally free and receiving local payments. So these are non-wire payments, they're direct deposits. This is the way that Amazon pays you. This is going to be totally free as well. So you're not going to run into any hidden charges every time you get paid by Amazon. Now, as mentioned, there is something to know about using Payoneer. And what that is that most people think that Payoneer is free as well. So when you come down here and it says directly by marketplaces, it says look at the marketplace to see if there are any fees. Via your accounts receivable, this would also be Amazon. It says it is free, but there's a small asterisk. What this is that if you have received less than $2,000 on an annual basis, so per year from Amazon, you have to pay $29. That is the hidden fee that Payoneer has. So guys, no matter where you are located in the world, you can still sign up for Amazon KDP and you can have US banking information. So all of this works seamlessly and you can do all of this totally for free. So you're not paying any fees every time you get paid. Okay, so once you've entered all of this information, just go ahead and click on add. And then very importantly, it's going to give you this little pop-up that says almost done. Click on save to save this information. So just scroll down and click on save right here. This is going to turn that from yellow to green, and it says that your bank information is confirmed and saved. Please make sure that when you are going through here, it changes from yellow to green. That means that your account is saved and you can actually get paid from Amazon. Okay, then scroll down to the bottom here. You're going to have one more section. This is filling out your tax information. I will talk about taxes here in a second. It is very easy to do. Doesn't matter where you are located in the world, but just click on complete tax questionnaire. And first off, it's just going to say, are you an individual or are you a business? This goes back to what did we select when we were creating this account? And then are you a United States citizen? So depending on what you select here, it's going to give you a different form to fill out for your taxes. So if you click on yes, this is going to bring you to this set of questions here. So it's going to have your full name, doing business as or trade name. You can just skip that, especially if you are doing this as an individual, and then social security number or your individual taxpayer identification number or employee identification number. So depending on which one of these that you have, that's what you can enter here. Social security number and your ITIN are going to be for you individually. If you have selected a business, then you can use your employee identification number. That is essentially your taxpayer number for your business entity. Now, a question that I often get is why does Amazon need your social security number to create an account? And the reason is we are signing up to make money from Amazon. So they are going to be paying us profits. They need to make sure that they are covering their own back and keeping track of who they are paying those profits to. Now, coming back up to the top here, if you were to select a business instead of an individual, it's going to change the questions that it asks you. The same thing goes for if you select an individual and you you say that you are not a US citizen. It's going to ask you one important question here that says, are you acting as an intermediate agent? Essentially someone who is receiving the profits on behalf of someone else. For most of you guys, it is going to look like this. So it's going to be individual. Are you a US citizen? No. Are you an intermediary agent? No. So far, all of this is the same, but once you come down to the bottom, it is going to be slightly different. This is going to say, do you have a non-US tax identification number? Yes or no. And what this is for you is in your local country or region, what is your identification number? Whatever that number is for you specifically, that is what you're going to enter here. Now, the really important thing for you guys to know is that if you are located outside of the United States, you do not have to pay taxes on the profits that you make from Amazon KDP to the United States. Even though Amazon is a United States company and you can even make sales on Amazon KDP books in the US, the money that is paid to you, you only have to pay tax in your local country or region. This is something that's really awesome to Amazon and makes the tax part of this process so easy. Now, if we scroll up just a little bit here, one more point that might be a little bit confusing is what is your country of citizenship and then where is your permanent address? So let's say that your country of citizenship is technically one country, but where you are permanently living is another country. Make sure that you specify that between these two boxes. So guys, once you fill out your tax information, you will get a green check mark down here. I'm not filling out all this information for this example, but then all you have to do is click on save and your account will be created. So guys, this is a good point to talk about how to handle taxes for Amazon KDP. And I do have to put a disclaimer here. I am not a tax advisor. I'm not giving you financial advice. This is how I understand that all of this works. So with that being said, no matter where you are located in the world, when you are getting paid from Amazon KDP, the way that you handle taxes is at the end of the year. So let's use 2024, for example. You add up how much money Amazon actually paid out to you. So how much you received in your bank account. Now you want to add up the amounts all the way from January 1st of 2024 to December 31st of 2024. So every single day throughout that year, how much money they paid out to you. Once you add that up to a total, all you have to do is add this to other income on your taxes. So when you are filing your taxes normally, as you do every year, you can add this as a section of other income. It's basically just side income that you made, and you put that total amount for that year in there. Now, in a second here, I'll give you a tip that will help you save money on these Amazon KDP taxes. However, it is really important to clarify that you're only paying tax adding up the amount that you received in that year. We're not looking at the amount that you have in your Amazon KDP dashboard for the year. The reason for this is that Amazon KDP pays you out your profits the next month. So technically, the amount of Amazon KDP profits that you earned the last month of 2024, they won't be paid out to you until the first month of 2025. So this is where there could be some discrepancies and you want to make sure that you're actually looking at your bank account to see how much money Amazon paid you out during that year. Now, with that being said, the little trick that you can use to save money on your taxes, if you are in the United States, this is called a Form Schedule C. And what this allows you to do is totally as an individual, so you don't need a business account to do this, you can write off any of your business expenses. So if you bought a computer for Amazon KDP, if you bought software for Amazon KDP, if you bought templates or anything that you spent money on directly related to this business, you are allowed to write that off against the profits that you made that year. So, for example, let's say that you made $5,000 in the first year of doing Amazon KDP. Well, let's say that you spent $2,000 on a computer, you spent $100 on software, that is $2,100 that you can deduct from that $5,000, so you're paying less tax. Now guys, that Form Schedule C works for the United States. I cannot say that that works for every country or region out there. There might be a different form or a different way to do that, but that concept of writing off your business expenses should hold true no matter where you are located. Now, the last thing that I will say about taxes is that once you get to about $50,000 in profit per year, that's when I would start looking into creating a business entity. Now, specifically, the business entity I would recommend to you is called a single member LLC. This is probably the easiest one to set up, and it creates something separate from you. What's cool about this is you can then open up a business bank account. That's free to do. You can pick what bank you'd like to have that open with. So all of the money that gets paid out from Amazon KDP is going into one business account. Everything stays super organized and it's very easy to keep track of how much you made during the year, and you can get some additional tax advantages for being a business. Now, again, I wouldn't worry about that until you get to at least $50,000 in profit per year. Until then, you can do all this as an individual and it's very easy and straightforward to do. Now, from here, if you guys haven't seen that full step-by-step tutorial that I was mentioning in the beginning of this video, I will put a link to it down in the description. It essentially takes off from this point. So once you have your account created, it will walk you through every single step of what kind of books to create on Amazon KDP that actually sell the best, how to create them step by step, and then how to upload them to Amazon KDP. I even give you my titles, subtitles, descriptions, everything that I use for my business, I share with you guys openly in that video. So guys, I hope this video has been helpful. If you have any questions at all, just let me know down in the comments. Otherwise, if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. I really would appreciate that. And I'll plan on seeing you guys all in the next video.